Hello everyone, welcome back to Jenda DIY. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet an open chest top. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. And for this top, I'm making in size small, and I also showing you how to make this bigger and measuring it on your body. Okay, now let's get into the video. First, we are going to make the bust part. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 110. It is equal 25 inches length. It's the measurement around my under bust. If you guys want it bigger, please add more chains. After you got your desired fit, next, we are going to connect the foundation chains together. Make sure that your foundation chains doesn't twist, and we are going to make slip stitch into the first chain. To make slip stitch, insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull through all the loops. Next, we are going to make half double crochet for row 1, chain 1, and make half double crochet into the next stitch. To make half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop. Yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. You can use stitch marker to mark at this first half double crochet. It is easy to know where to make slip stitch at the end of the row. Keep repeating this into every chain around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch into the first half double crochet stitch to connect the row. After you have made a slip stitch, and this is what the first row looks like. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into the stitch near chain 1. Continue make half double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, for the small loop that needs chain 1, it doesn't count as a stitch, so we are going to skip it and make slip stitch into the stitch that we mark. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 17. It is equal 5 inches length. It's the height of my top. If you guys want your top longer, please add more rows. And this is what the bust part looks like after you reach row 17, and it measuring from my under bust to the underarm. Like I said, if you guys want your top longer, please add more rows. Next, we are going to make the front part of the top. Please use stitch marker to mark at the other corner of the top. We are going to separate it into two parts, which is the front part and the back part. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 18, chain 1, turn your work, skip one stitch that near chain 1, and then we are going to make half double crochet decrease into the next stitch by make half double crochet 2 together. To make half double crochet decrease, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the next loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 4 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 4 loops. And this is how we made half double crochet 2 together. Don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at this decreasing stitch. It is easy to know where your first or the last stitch is. Then continue make half the bokeh shade into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches from the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you had 3 last stitches from the stitch marker, then we are going to make half the bokeh shade decrease by make half the bokeh shade 3 together. We decrease the same thing like we did at the beginning of the row. The difference is we insert the hook into the next 3 loops. After you got 5 loops on your hook, then yarn over and pull through all 5 loops. And this is how we made half the bokeh shade 3 together. Next, for row 19 and row 20, chain 1, turn your work and make decrease by make half the bokeh shade 2 together. Then continue make half the bokeh shade into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches. Then I will meet you back again. After you had 2 last stitches, then we are going to make half the bokeh shade decrease by make half the bokeh shade 2 together. After you got 3 rows of decreasing stitch, and this is what it looks like. If you guys want the underarm part more curved or the chest part smaller, please add more decreasing rows by repeat row 19. Next, we are going to make the V part, which is the curved part of the open chest top, as you can see in this picture. To begin, count 9 stitches from the corner and use stitch marker to mark at the 10th stitch. Then count the same number to the other side. Next, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 1, chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to make half the bokeh shade decrease by make half the bokeh shade 2 together. Then continue make half the bokeh shade into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches from the stitch marker. Then we are going to make decrease by make half the bokeh shade 2 together. For for the next row, we are going to repeat row 1. It means that we are going to keep decreasing at both sides of the row until there is no stitch left to decrease. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to repeat the same thing to the other side. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch that you mark. And keep decreasing at the both side of the row until there is no stitch left to decrease. Then I will meet you back again. and this is what it looks like. You must have furrows for both sides. Next, we are going to make the upper part of the open chest top, as you can see in this picture. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is. Furrow 1, chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to make increase by make 2 half double crochet in the same stitch. As you can see, we have one loop or one stitch left from the decreasing row, and we are going to make 2 half double crochet into that stitch. Remember, chain 1 doesn't count as a stitch. After you got 2 half double crochet in the same stitch, next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to make increase into the stitch near chain 1. After you have made increase, then make half double crochet into the last stitch. For the next row, chain 1, turn your work. Remember, for the increasing part, make sure that the increasing stitch is faced inside of the top, as you can see in this picture. For row 3, make half double crochet into every stitch until you have one last stitch. Then we are going to make increase. After you have made increase, for the next row, please keep repeating row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 5, then I will meet you back again. After you reach row 5, and this is what it looks like, and this is the outside part of the top, which is near the underarm part, and as you can see, the increasing part is faced inside. After you reach row 5, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to make the other side. So as you can see, this is the right side of the stitch. We are going to turn it and working on the wrong side of the stitch. To begin, attach the yarn. For row 1, chain 1, and make increase into the stitch that we attached the yarn by make 2 half double crochet in the same stitch. After because you have made two half double crochet in the same stitch. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into the stitch near chain 1. After you have made a half double crochet, then make increase into the last stitch. Next, for row 3, chain 1, turn your work and make increase into the stitch near chain 1. Then continue make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 5, then I will meet you back again. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 5. It is the same number like the first side. Next, for row 6, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until you have one last stitch, then we are going to make increase. After you have made increase, then continue make 26 chains and I will meet you back again. And this is where I got my 26 chains from. It's from the bottom part, which is near the decreasing part. As you can see, we are going to skip the first stitch that near the decreasing stitch and then start count from the next stitch. Keep counting the number of the stitch until you reach the other side. So we are going to skip one last stitch that near decreasing stitch the same like the first side. In total, I have 26 stitches, so I have to make 26 chains the same. If you have different numbers, please follow your measurement. Next, we are going to connect the chain into the other side by make half double crochet. So continue from where your last stitch is, make sure that your chain doesn't twist, and then we are going to make increase into the first stitch by make two half double crochet into the same stitch. After you have made increase, then continue make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. In total, you must have 6 rows of increasing stitch like the other side. And you must have 7 stitches the same. And this is what the open chest looks like. Next, Continue from where your last stitch is for row 1 until row 7, chain 1, turn your work, and make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. Then we meet you back again. This is what it looks like after you reach row 7. If you guys want it longer, please add more rows. And for the measuring from the decreasing row until the last row, it is equal 6 inches. It is the measurement from the underarm to my neck, as you can see in this picture. So for you guys that make it bigger, please add more rows until you reach your neck. Please always try it on your body to see what it looks like. Next, we are going to make the shoulder part, which is also the neckline. Turn your top into two pieces and use stitch marker to mark at the middle part. Then skip the stitch that you mark and start count from the next stitch. Count 5 stitches and use stitch marker to mark at the 6th stitch. And then count the same number to the other side. For the measurement from the first stitch marker until the 3rd stitch marker, it is equal 3 inches. If you guys want your neckline bigger, please count more stitches and mark it. Next, continue from where your last stitch is. For row 1, chain 1, turn your work, and make half double crochet into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches from the stitch marker. Then I will meet you back again. After you have 3 last stitches from the stitch marker, then we are going to make decrease by make half double crochet 3 together. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, and make decrease by make half double crochet 2 together. Then continue make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. For the next row, please keep repeating row 1 and row 2 until you reach row 4, then I will meet you back again. And if you guys want the shoulder part smaller, please add more decreasing row by repeat row 1 and row 2. After you reach row 4, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. Next, we are going to repeat the same thing to the other side. As you can see, this is the right side of the stitch, so turn your top and we are working on the wrong side of the stitch. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch that you mark. For row 1, chain 1 and skip one stitch that you attach the yarn and make decrease into the next stitch by make half double crochet 2 together. Then continue make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until you have two last stitches. Then we are going to make decrease and make half double crochet 2 together. For row 3, chain 1, turn your work and make decrease by make half double crochet 3 together. Then continue make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. For row 4, please repeat row 2. Remember, for both shoulder parts, must be have the same number of the row. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the neckline or the shoulder part looks like. And now we have finished the front part. Next, we are going to make the back part of the top. Turn your top and we are working on the wrong side of the stitch. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch near the decreasing stitch. For row 1, chain 1 and skip the stitch that you have attached the yarn and then make decrease into the next stitch by make half double crochet 2 together. Then continue make half double crochet into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches from the corner, then I will meet you back again. After you have 3 last stitches from the corner, then we are going to make decrease by make half double crochet 3 together. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make decrease by make half double crochet 2 together. Then continue make half double crochet into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches. Then we are going to make decrease by make half double crochet 2 together. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 until you reach row 5. It means that we are going to keep decreasing until we have the same number of the stitches. like the front side, which is the normal part. There is no decrease. This is the part that I got the number of the stitches from. Example that your front part have 30 stitches, so you have to keep decreasing at the both side of the row until you have 30 stitches. After you reach row 5, next for row 6 until row 11, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. So from row 5 until row 11, no decrease or increasing stitch. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 11. For this normal half double crochet row, you can make less row or make more row, it's up to you want. And if you want this back hole more deeper, please make less row than mine, because the deeper of this back hole, the more bigger of the neck hole is. So when the neck hole is bigger, it's easy to insert your head through when you're wearing the top. Next, we are going to separate both sides to make this back hole. Fold it into two pieces and use stitch marker to mark at the middle part. Then continue from where your last stitch is for row 12, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches. Then we are going to make decrease by make half double crochet 3 together. Next, for row 13 until row 21, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. So from row 13 until row 21, just make no more half double crochet row, no decrease. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 21. It is the same number like the front part, which is the neck part. So you still have 4 more rows left to make the shoulder part. Next, we are going to make the back shoulder part. But first, count the number of the stitches of the first row of the shoulder part. As you can see, for the first row of my shoulder part, you have to count include the stitch that you attach the yarn and the stitch that you decrease. In total, I have 13 stitches. So for the back part, I have to count the same number. And use stitch marker to mark at the 13th stitch. The purpose of doing this because we want the front shoulder part and the back shoulder part have the same number of the stitches. Next, continue from where your last stitch is and we are going to make decreasing stitch for 4 rows. Make sure that the decreasing stitch is face inside like the front part. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach row 4, it is the same number like the front part. Then turn it wrong side out and we are going to connect both shoulder parts together. Chain 1, then make single crochet both sides together. To make single crochet, insert the hook into both sides loop, yarn over and pull through both loops, and now you have 2 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through 2 loops. Keep repeating this into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what it looks like, and this is what the right side looks like. Next, we are going to make the other side. To begin, attach the yarn into the stitch that you mark. For row 1, chain 1 and skip the stitch that you attach the yarn, and then make the crease into the next stitch by make half double crochet 2 together. Then continue make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. For row 2 until row 10, chain 1, turn your work and make half double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row. So for row 2 until row 10, just make no more half double crochet row, no decrease. After you reach row 10, next we are going to make the shoulder part by repeat the same thing like the other side. To begin, count 13 stitches the same. And use stitch marker to mark at the 13th stitch. So for my last stitch of row 10, it's face inside. I have to cut it off and then attach the yarn into the stitch that we mark. Then continue make decreasing stitch for 4 rows. Make sure that the decreasing stitch is face inside. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach row 4, then turn it wrong side out and single crochet both sides together like we did at the first shoulder part. After you reach the end of the row, then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what it looks like after we have attached the shoulder part together. And this is what the neckline hole looks like. Make sure that it's big enough for your head to go through. Next, we are going to make single crochet as the border around this chest hole. To begin, attach the yarn and chain 1. Then single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. Thank you. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Then chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what it looks like after you have made single crochet around this hole. Next, we are going to make single crochet around these armholes by repeat the same thing like we did at the chest hole. Next, we are going to make single crochet around this neckline hole. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner part. Then continue making single crochet around the neckline, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch into the first single crochet stitch. Next, we are going to make the ribbing around the neck part. Continue from where your last stitch is. For row 1, chain 2 and make half double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the other corner. Then I will meet you back again. Next, for row 2, chain 2, turn your work and make half double crochet into the stitch near chain 2. After you have made a half double crochet, next we are going to make front post half double crochet. to make front post half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook in front of the post and through the post. Then yarn over and pull through the post, pull it a little bit, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And this is how we made front post half double crochet. Next, we are going to make back post half double crochet. To make back post half double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook behind the post and through the post. Yarn over and pull through the post. Pull it a little bit, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops. And this is how we made back post half double crochet. Please keep alternating front post and back post half double crochet into every stitch around until you reach the other corner. Then I will meet you back again. Remember, chain 2 doesn't count as a stitch. After you reach the end of the row, next for row 3, chain 2, turn your work, and we are going to make front post half double crochet into this front post stitch. After you have made a front post, then we are going to make back post into the back post half double crochet stitch. Keep repeating this into every stitch around until you have one last stitch, then I will meet you back again. So you have one last stitch. It is the stitch that we make half double crochet. Then make a half double crochet into that stitch. Next, for row 4, please repeat row 2. If you guys want it longer, please keep repeating row 2 and row 3. This is what it looks like after you reach row 4. Next, we are going to make the string for tie the back neckline. Continue from where your last stitch is and make 60 chains. If you guys want it longer, please add more chains. After you got 60 chain, then leave a long tail of yarn and cut it off. Next, attach the yarn into the other side corner. And then make 60 chain the same number like the first side. And this is what both string looks like. For the remaining yarn, please use the needle to weave in. And now your open chest top is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.